Yo, what up guys, Starship Go here, this is my Karakuru Piri Rice deck. Had my attempt at one. Now, with this build, I wanted to create a variant of the deck where you actually focus on Karakuri cards. Because one could easily just go into Aurora, Don Turbo, Shabba Dashboard Jet and go from there. Is that really why you want to play Karakuri? So this is the least possible variant, competitive variant probably of Karakuri. This is a somewhat focused pure variant attempt at. Just focus on some of the big Karakuris, perhaps using them as boss, using them as draw power, use cards like Graphic Collapse to abuse them. It's not a competitive build, okay? If you want a competitive build, I could make one. If you guys want another Karakuri build. This is more for the people that actually want some Karakuri deck cards in the Karakuri deck with Karakuri monsters. But yeah, if that's not your style, then this is not your profile. Unless I'll show you the main combo that exists in this deck, or at least one of the main cool interactions. So this card is now searchable with the Piri Rice mod, by the way. That's why you got Piri Rice. And if you normal summon that, during your main phase, you can normal summon an additional Karakuri, basically. So let's say you open these two at the machine dupe for the Ninishi. This is something you could theoretically do for your board. This is basically a deep draw combo, which I think is pretty cool. So you just summon two Ninishi from your deck, you go into Burai. Go into Burai Do. Summon another level 4, go into another Burai. Theoretically, you could summon level 5s, but then you get the issue that they have kind of breaks in your hand, you can't just easily normal summon them. Go into another Burai. Go into another Burai though. Summon whatever monster. Use that effect. Draw 3. Now the shuffler is disabled, so you kind of get free after draws here. Needed to attack here, it wasn't even optional because of the Karakuri effect. I can use it again to draw 3 more cards. Yeah, it's pretty good, right? Let's just see the 6 draws. Sadly, we used all 3 level 1s here, so there is no possibility to go to level 9. We don't run a level 10. We don't run a level 2 tuner in here. So it would just be an additional card that I want a consistent build. So yeah, it's just basically a deep draw Karakuri variant that wants to draw into Gravity Collapse, basically. You also run Pot of Everest to recycle the Karakuri, so we can do this multiple times. You run a few boss with an extract, but yeah, let's get through it, I guess. We run a total of level 4 level 4 non-tuners. To combine with the Nishi to go into Burai. Makes sense, right? We run 6 copies of the Nishi due to Piri Rice map. Which is the best normal sum to open, because it combines really well with Cash Cash. I don't know how to pronounce this stuff. Not native English speakers, so some words like that can be a bit tricky at times still. But regardless, basically you can use this to switch the battle position of the Nishi and then search what level 4s. Of course, this could theoretically also work with an Nishi, although you do need an additional normal summon in order to make it truly really work. Otherwise, you just have a level 5 synchro possibly. Now, granted, we don't run one because I just ran out of space, but you could theoretically run Chambara. Do you really want to use 2 months to go to Chambara in 2021? I don't think so. 3 of this, mostly just targets for Karakuri synchros. Makes sense, right? 1 instant fusion, 3 red hordes. We can either go to Cybersaurus or Seamoth of Theseus. That combined with the Nidishi just directly goes into Burido. Because this is a machine, we can just use it, it's fine. We can also use this combined with this to go into the Burai. So these are basically our best cards, we can't rely on them however, sadly, so. Yeah, we maximized our amount, but still. Not exactly great. We run 3 duplications to work with both Inashishi and Ninishi. Yeah, that also makes sense. I hope 3 Everest because we can just we really go fast through our monsters, and this will always basically be life turn 1. It's a pot of greed basically in those situations. It also recycles resources, so we can actually do things beyond turn 1. 1 upstart to run 39 cards, search spell, another search spell, but this basically searches the Ninishi, which is the card we want to open in this deck. 3 Anatomy, so this is kind of okay. Basically whenever a Karakuri monster switches spell position, you place a counter on it, gets sent to the graveyard. Draw 1 card for each counter, which you always have to do with 2 counters. And we just run this to get an additional extender. Just can revive any Karakuri monster, including the big boys. But it also ensures if you open this, you can just easily go for another synchro without needing to open machine dupe. Besides, to run it at once, is it hard once per turn, it's not exactly great. If you break this card, it's gonna help you, it's just a decent extender. And arguably Monster Reborn could also be used here, but yeah, deck space is also a thing. 3 Imperms, good going first, going second. Craft Collapse, basically win condition, we hope to draw into this, and then Tribute one to Karakurishin goes to make them able to basically summon anything that turn. So 2 Instant Fusion targets, 1 Baroness the Fleur, I just like running this, but if you're playing this TCG, you replace it with Chandra. Then again, you need to wait for Retort Fusion anyway, because it's also OG exclusive, so yeah. So basically, negate, which is nice. This is also a really nice boss monster to just sit on, even though it's just a Trident with extra steps. It's still a Trident with extra steps, which is decent. Although this one banishes. Crystal Wing, we can make it, and it can just be a negate, or it can out things. 3 Berider and 3 Burai, we just maximize the Karakuri Synchro, since this is a Karakuri Synchro focus deck. Now, if you need to get rid of something, we can theoretically go into this. And of course, if you're going first, you can also use 2 Berider to go into this. Yeah, it's far from the best Karakuri list ever, I'm not gonna lie. But once again, there's more of an variant focus on actually running the Karakuri cards. I think the Karakuri cards be the face of the deck, and yeah, just not go Aurora Dawn Turbo, which I could do for another build. But yeah, I just wanted to make a fun Karakuri build, so here you go. One that doesn't just turbo out Aurora Dawn, if you like that. If you still want an Aurora Dawn variant, I can make that soon, but also, don't worry. But yeah, I hope you guys liked it. Start signing out. Peace. Going fast makes me feel alive. My heartbeat.